Hey guys, this is Chase from Alta Labs. I want to give you some quick pointers on how to manually plan and set up your 2.4 and 5 GHz channels and the bandwidth selection utilized for maximum Wi-Fi performance in your projects. These steps will help maximize the amount of available bandwidth usable by your client devices. Let's assume you already have set up your account and site at manage.alta.inc or using our mobile apps. Once your access points are installed and set up in your site, the first thing you will need to do is set up your SSID. For this example, we are going to set up a basic SSID with a single password and allow the SSID to broadcast both bands. This enables your access points to use the built-in scan feature. Once you hit save on the new SSID, we are going to click the Network tab and open the settings window of one or more of your access points. We'll start by adjusting the bandwidth. Before we actually select a channel, let's take a step back and look at your project as a whole. We need to identify how many other Alta Labs access points, or APs, each individual AP will hear. We will call these Peer APs. By doing this, we can correctly choose the appropriate bandwidth to choose in each of your access points. Click the Scan tab on the AP device window. Note, this will soon be Info instead of Scan. And run a full scan. If you see 5 or more 5 GHz Peer APs in the list, i.e., APs that are broadcasting the same SSID as the current AP within 5 GHz, then it is recommended to use a narrower channel bandwidth in order to avoid any overlapping 80 MHz channels. If there are more than 10, it is recommended to go as narrow as 20 MHz. With more wireless clients connected to your network, you will want to leverage the narrower option to keep the broadcast environment as clean as possible. This will improve your overall throughput on a per-client device basis. If you find that APs are not using the channels you've previously configured, it's likely that the AP detected radar or other interference. Using a narrower channel will reduce the chances of detecting radar in the future. In this case, if an AP has switched the channels during the day, it will automatically reset back to the configured channel during the night. As a best practice, we suggest keeping the 2 GHz bandwidth at 20 MHz to also keep yours and other RF environments as clean as possible. Many client devices on 2 GHz will actually require your access points to revert back to 20 MHz, even if you have selected 40 MHz bandwidth. You will notice under the 5 GHz bandwidth option that there is a 160 MHz option. While this is blisteringly fast in some cases, this speed can actually cause some incompatibility issues with some client devices, and we would discourage your use of this as a result. If your specific project calls for this bandwidth, or if you know you have client devices that will support 160 MHz, feel free to use this bandwidth. Be sure to hit save once you have selected your bandwidths. Next, channel selection on each of your radios. Before you actually select any of your channels, we want to review some best practices. When picking your channel for 2.4 GHz, it is strongly recommended you choose channel 1, 6, or 11, while avoiding using the same channel on access points that are nearby each other. By following this guideline, you are ensuring that your access points are enabled to send and receive as quickly as possible. Otherwise, your access point has to wait for any traffic on the adjacent AP broadcasting on channel 1, for example, to stop before it can resume on channel 1. On your 5 GHz band, as allowed by local regulation, we recommend utilizing DFS channels as they are typically underutilized and pristine. This allows for much faster transmit and receive speeds. These generally start at channel 52 and end at 144, but can vary by country. Similar to 2.4 GHz, we recommend you try and keep access points that are closest to each other on separate channels. Now, let's select what channels work best for your project by once again leveraging the scan feature built into the Alta Labs access points. We always suggest using the full scan to capture a more accurate result of what your RF environment looks like. Once completed, you will be presented with a summary of what each specific AP is seeing inside your project. For our example, on the 2 GHz band, you can see my channel 11 is congested by the dark orange indicator. If I hover over that, I can see how many wireless interferers there are and what the strongest SSID it can see that it is not broadcasting. Based on these results, channel 1 is my best option. Even though channels 2 through 5 and 7 through 10 may appear to look better, it is still recommended to avoid these as using them will interfere with non-overlapping channels 1, 6, and 11. In reviewing my 5 GHz band, I can see that my channel 56 is a great option since there is hardly any utilization and congestion on this channel. Once you have made your channel selections, be sure to hit save. From there, I'm going to repeat the bandwidth selection, then scan, then select the best channel based on results provided in the scan for each access point. Be sure to vary the channels on access points that are the closest. You'll notice that there is an auto channel option found under both the 2.4 and 5 GHz bands. This is generally a safe option to choose, but please be aware that the AP will only automatically choose the best channel immediately following a power cycle or reboot. It will then remain on that channel until the next reboot. After you've made your channel and bandwidth selections, it is important to periodically monitor the channel utilization on each of your APs to ensure the highest performance possible and determine whether any further changes are needed to be made. Take a look at the network device table as traffic passes through your Wi-Fi network. Pay attention to the small Wi-Fi icons under the load header. If any of these icons is orange or red, indicating 50% or higher channel utilization by other APs for extended periods of time, it is a good idea to select a different channel or bandwidth for that specific AP and band. You can even review the average channel utilization for the past hour, 2 days, or 2 months by selecting the time period at the top. Finally, we understand that these recommendations should cover most projects. There may be project types that require very different strategies for bandwidth and channel selection. If you have any further questions about channel and bandwidth planning and selection, or if you feel your project is unique and requires something different than what we have recommended, please come engage with us in our community forum at forum.alta.inc. Thank you.